What up, G-Life? It's your boy, MC Shadow, back at you with another video. Make sure you like, make sure you comment, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and if possible, share. Make sure to check out the place where I have all the videos and their own photos make the video looking for a lot easier. Now, what I wanted to talk about was actually a question that got asked by one of my subscribers, and I always say, you ask a question, I will make a video answering it. You know, the homie Cheap Primer, he asked if I could make a video talking about who do I think killed President JF Kennedy, because he likes my videos where I break down stuff. And gracias, my boy. I do appreciate the support. Honestly, I do. Now, who do I think killed President JF Kennedy? I have heard so many different versions of this tale, from the magical bullet to the aliens to all kinds of shit. And it's always the most irrational shit that people pick. Like, out of all the things, this is what you're gonna go with? Wow. Sometimes I think that they do it on purpose to either, like, tick me off or just to mess with me or something like that. But because I refuse to believe that somebody could possibly believe that this is what's going on, this shape-shifting reptiles, and I refuse to believe that somebody could actually think that. But anyway, going off topic. Now, who do I think killed President JF Kennedy? Well, from what I gathered and the research and going into, you know, Mr. JF Kennedy's life, career and presidency, there's a few things that stand out. One, you know, he tended to rub elbows with a lot of crooked individuals, a lot of guys from the Italian mafia. And this is no conspiracy theory. There's pictures and everything like that. JF Kennedy was also good friends with Frank Sinatra. Frank Sinatra, who was an associate to the Italian mafia. Everyone knows that. It's, you know, it's all out there and everything like that. That's no secret. You know, and at that time, the mob, the Italian mafia, that's when they were at their strongest, right? That's when they were, that's when the mob was in their prime, homie, right there, homie. They had all kinds of soldiers everywhere and associates. My boy, that's when they were blowing shit. My boy, they had that shit on lockdown. Okay? Now, JF Kennedy's brother decided, you know, who was the governor, he decided to go after the Italian mob, right? Hitting them with all kinds of RICOs. And this is the first time that the Italian mob had suffered blows like that, right? Like, they were actually losing, and a lot of the guys were going away for a long, long time. That had never happened before, my boy. They would always win their cases. But JF Kennedy's brother, you know, he didn't want to let it go, my boy. It was his mission to bring down the mob. So these guys had already warned, you know, them to back off, or it was going to be on and cracking. The homie said, "The fuck, I'm not going to let no fucking thugs intimidate me." So he still went after them. Frank Sinatra even told JF Kennedy, "Hey, man, you should probably tell your brother he needs to cut it, homie, because these fools ain't liking it, homie. These fools are losing a lot of money now, and it's going all bad." Vato, he's the president, my boy. He couldn't, homie. He had to stick to his guns, homie. So he was like, "Nah, homie, if they're bad people, they gotta go away." The incident happens where the guy, Williams Waldberg, whatever, the killer, shoots JF Kennedy, kills him. He was an associate to the Italian mafia. He was an associate. You guys could go and check. It's not made up, it's not fabricated. He was an associate to the Italian mob. Here's where the story takes a turn. A trippy one, too. This guy ends up getting killed by Jack Ruby. The guy, JF Kennedy's killer, ends up getting killed by Jack Ruby, who runs with the Italian mafia. I mean, people could piece the story together, right? You get what I'm saying? I mean, what's making more logical sense? This or a magical bullet or aliens or the Russian government working with the United States government under, for some odd reason, the conspiracy theory for God knows what? It doesn't even make any sense. Like, what could really be attained out of all of this? But anyhow, okay, whatever. I'm going to go ahead and say that this is the one that makes more logical sense. Now, why did they never release this information? Simple. They are not going to give no credit to the Italian mafia, to this gang, to these thugs. Can you believe that this fucking street organization was able to take out the president of the United States? Embarrassment. Or to think that they're that powerful. No, they can't give them that glory. That's glory, my boy, and they can't give them that. They refuse. They'd rather lie their asses off than to say what really happened. That's not glorifying. It's being fucking honest, telling the truth. But see, they were afraid if they released this information. Now, if they were able to get to the president of the United States, who the fuck is going to testify against these guys? They were able to get the president of the United States. You think somebody's going to want to go to court and testify against them now? Does that not make sense? You get what I'm saying? Is it possible that fucking thugs get to the president? Yes. Yes, it is. It's crazy. The streets get very treacherous. See, the thing is that a lot of people have a lot of skeletons in their closets. Not everybody's hands are clean in these games. Not even in politics. You know, President Hoover, you know, had his running with the mobs. You know, had some, you know, business under the table with them. Several presidents, several mayors with the tally mob. Public record, you guys can look this shit up. I ain't making it up. So I'm going to have to go ahead and say that they had a role in playing, you know, because think of it like this. He whacks, you know, the president. He gets busted now, and he's, you know, he's hysterical because he's not all there. So now they see him as a liability. Like, shit, man, this was going to fucking come and rat us all out. So now they got to take him out. Because the reason why he killed that guy is he insulted Jews. That he made a Jewish joke, and that's why he had to go smoke him. Which version are you going to believe? He shot and killed him because he made a Jewish joke and he got offended? Or because this guy's from the Italian mafia, this fool potentially is going to throw rat now in your guys' organization. Someone's got to take him out. You brought him in. I mean, which one makes the more logical sense? You get what I'm saying? Or we could just say it was aliens or reptiles. I mean, whatever. I mean, whatever floats your guys' boat. In my personal opinion, based off of what I have, you know, gathered. Now, I'm not saying that they had something to do with it. I'm just saying that from the looks of it, in my opinion, you know, it seems like there might have been some happening or something, you know what I mean? But like I said, that's just my guess on it, you know what I mean? But that's the one that makes more logical sense to me. I'd rather go with that version than to say that it was a magic bullet or anything like that, you know? I live in the real world, so I could only go based off of real things and stuff that makes logical sense. So I'm going to go ahead and say that version of the tale. At least that's just my opinion, my boy. You guys can feel free to, you know, however, you know, you see it. You know, and I know it's like, no, stupid. These fucking thugs can't get to the president. These low lives. They wish that they could make moves like that. Like, okay. You know what I mean? There's a reason why people say, you know, these organizations are deadly and they're not to be messed with. It's a brutal game, man. So I tell people, stay in school, raise your kids better, man. This shit ain't no joke, bro. You know, death lurking in every corner, and you literally get nothing out of it. It's messed up. It's a cold game. You know, why look over your shoulder? It's, you know, better you could just be getting in and, you know, living your life. I'm just saying. But that's just my opinion on who I think whack JFK and why. But there's that video, my boy. There you go. Gracias for the support. I really do appreciate it, carnal. We out.